Hi everyone, I am stepping outside of my comfort zone today and making a video. I don't like how I look on camera, but I thought I'd give it a shot. a couple of weeks ago, I stumbled on to a website called Dan Company, and the idea of the website is that you get clothes that fit you and you have a stylist. Somebody picks out some clothes based on your body type. So basically on the website, when you first go, they ask you a bunch of questions. You know, what's your body type? Are you heavy on top, heavy on bottom? Your basic questions, you know, what's your height? What size clothes do you wear? What bra size do you wear? What parts of your body are you comfortable showing off, and what parts of your body do you like to keep covered? That was a pretty big deal because every woman has parts of her body that she just doesn't want to show. And the next question that they asked was what kind of styles do you like, and what's your budget? So, as far as the styles go, it's basic questions about tops, bottoms, skirts, outerwear, dresses, accessories, stuff like that. You can pick anything that you want, really. And the prices concerned me a little bit, because one of the questions was, you know, how much do you normally spend on different items? And the options that they have are 50 to 100, 100 to 150, and 150 to 200. And then there's another option as low as you can go. Of course, that's the one that I picked for everything. They ask, what kinds of things do you want to see in your box? Do you want accessories? How often do you dress for certain occasions? And there's a lot of questions. And then they give you a space that you can tell them if there's anything that you really want to tell them about. Unfortunately, they only give you about 500 characters. So there's not a whole lot for you to describe yourself to your stylist. I had to go back and edit and re-edit, and it's basically like describing everything about you in two tweets. That's about the length that you get. So there's not a whole lot. But what they do with the website is you pay $20. They send you a box of clothes, and then you can decide if you want to keep the clothes or send them back. Either you don't like the style, or maybe it doesn't fit, or, you know, for whatever reason. So I got my first box, and let's open it and see what's in it. So the box came, it's a pretty small box. I was a little worried about what I was going to find in it, because they send you, I think, 5 items for the $20 that you spend. And if you decide to keep any of the clothes, you put that $20 towards the clothing that you keep. And I had answered the questions and said, you know, I didn't want dresses, I didn't want formal clothing, I didn't want, you know, a lot of girly stuff. I didn't want anything that was pink or white, because they just make me look terrible. So this was the size of the box, and I thought, how'd they fit 5 things in there? So when you open the box, the very first thing you get is a return bag, and a pretty big bag. and return is free. Shipping both ways is free. So that's definitely a plus. The second thing that comes in the bag or in the box is a breakdown of the items that you got in the box and the prices. And the second thing is a little note from your stylist. Basically, welcome to the family. We're excited to start this journey with you and build a wardrobe you'll love to wear every day. I wanted to focus on comfort for you. I included two of our greatest bottoms. Yeah, it goes on and on, and it's basically just, you know, a little letter from the stylist saying this is what she thought of when she was picking the items for you. So we'll come back to this. Now, as far as the items that were in the box, the first thing I pulled out was a pair of leggings that are jean material. The brand is Lissy. The tags on them, it seems like a quality company. They're leggings. There's no pockets, but the inside has a stretchy inside, almost like it's supposed to really squish you in a little bit and help you look not so lumpy. So that was the very first thing I pulled out. The next item is a black sleeveless shirt. It is very soft, almost like a silky material. I believe it's pretty much Lycra. I'm not entirely sure here. The tags don't say. Oh, on the inside. Yeah, I don't have my glasses on, so this is a little difficult to read. Anyway, so it's a sleeveless, basically a t-shirt, and it's black, and you probably can't see it at the moment, but there is a triangle shape in the, at the neck, so that you can actually see through a little bit. So when I try them on, we'll have to see what it looks like. The next item was another t-shirt. Same material, the same very soft, silky, and it's purple. And it has this interesting detail here in the side where it looks like it's twisted up. I don't know how easy this is to see, but so, again, good quality. The brand on this is East Adeline. And it seems like it's going to be a long enough t-shirt to cover what I want covered. So we'll see when I try it on. The next item was another pair of leggings that are from the same company, Lissy, and they have the same stretchy material on the inside. I guess to just really gather in your stomach. The gray is it's a little difficult to really see, but it has a little bit of a pattern in it. It's not exactly something that I am thrilled about. The back of these has a line. It goes all the way down the back of the pants. It's sewn in, and that's on the back, not the front. I'm not quite sure what that's all about, but so yeah, they're like I said, another pair of leggings. They're soft, they're stretchy, and they're gray, like a heather gray. And then the last item that was in the box is a two-toned cardigan. Not really quite sure about this one. It's sort of sleeveless in a way. It has I don't know, it's just kind of open and then sewn down the sides here, but and it's fairly long. It's a very heavy jersey material. It's not quite sweater material, but it's not quite jersey material either. I'm not sure what you would call this. So that is the item, the cardigan. It is, like I said, it is fairly long. And we'll see what happens when I try this on. Okay, so I'm back with one of the items, or two of the items actually. The pants, I'm not very thrilled with. They seem to fit okay. They're a little bit too tight. They show every roll in my body, particularly in my stomach area. The shirt, it would have been a good length. I like my shirts to hang down and cover my belly. But this little detail here in the shirt, where it looks like it's twisted up inside of itself, that prevents it from laying down here. So it's not something I would be comfortable wearing. It doesn't cover enough. The sleeves are interesting. And one of the things that I had said when I made my order is that I don't like really to show off my arms. And yet they sent me a shirt that is open in the sides. It hangs loose, and when I put my arm up, it just falls down to the side, and that's not very comfortable for me, because I don't like showing my arms. I don't like showing my belly either, so I keep trying to pull the shirt down. That's not working so well. So yeah, this is the purple shirt and the gray leggings that have, I didn't notice the time when to put them on. They have a zipper here at the ankle. And that seam in the back, it comes right down here. I don't see any purpose for it. But so this is, yeah, this is how the pants look and the shirt, and it's not a very comfortable look for me. Okay, so here we have the cardigan. Gray on the outside and a rust-ish orange on the inside. The black shirt and the jean capris leggings. So we'll start with the cardigan. None of the edges are actually finished. There's no stitching at all on any of the edges. The inside, where the stitching comes together, it's all pretty raw, and I don't even know if this is supposed to be a collar, or I have no idea how this is supposed to be worn. I don't know. It's not something that I would choose to wear normally. The sleeves, like I said, they're very open, and then they're sewn together to the bottom with this weird inside. There's pockets on either side. The pockets are not quite big enough to hold a cell phone without it falling out, and the weight of my phone actually pulls this cardigan down way too much. It's a good length. It's just not a style that I would choose to wear. I don't even think it looks flattering on me at all. So that's the cardigan, and this I'm really not happy with. I do not like to show off my arms, and yet the stylist sent me a sleeveless shirt. Now, the length of the front of this is good. The length of the back, it actually has an additional little bit of fabric on the back, I guess, to cover your butt, which I would rather have it on the front than the back. And the triangular, I don't know if you can see this or not, it is slightly see-through, which is fine. I mean, I'm okay with this part of it. I'm not okay with the sleeves, or lack of sleeves, and the length is okay. The length covers what I need to be covered. The jean capris, they look a little bit better to me than the gray ones, only because they're darker and they hide a little bit more. But they're not functional at all. There's no pockets. There's nothing. I don't carry a purse, so my wallet, my phone, everything goes into my jeans if I leave the house, and they're not functional for me. I mean, they look okay. That strip is holding in my belly a little bit, but still, you know, without the shirt covering things, it still shows every roll, and I do not like every roll to be seen. So, I'll be back to go over the prices. So, now that I'm back, let's take a look at the prices here. The gray leggings. It says Porto cropped legging with zipper detail. Light gray, charcoal gray. these. $79. I would not, in my wildest dreams, pay $79 for a pair of leggings. The cardigan. Savannah double-faced cardigan. Charcoal gray and brown. I would argue that that's not brown, that is orange rust. In any case, that also $79. Yeah, that's way out of my league. This purple t-shirt with the knotted detail. It's called Jasmine Knotted V-Neck Tee in purple. This is the least expensive item, and it's $45. $45 for a t-shirt. The black sleeveless top. Called a Catalina top in black. This is $55 for a sleeveless t-shirt. And last but not least, the jean material leggings that out of everything was probably the only thing that I somewhat liked, except there's no pockets. There's no function to them. They're called Milan Denim Legging Capri. Dark wash is the color. These are $59. So it looks like there's nothing that I'm going to be keeping from this box. I like my clothes to have style, something that looks decent on me, something that covers my belly and my arms. I'm okay with my shoulders being seen, just not my arms. I'm alright with my chest, my cleavage being seen, that doesn't bother me. I'm not okay with this area being seen. And then the prices, they're just way, way too expensive. Even with the $20 styling fee, I would still have to pay another, you know, $25 for that, for the purple t-shirt. And that's just way too expensive. So I'm gonna send the stuff back and, I'm going to give them one more shot and see if they will send me anything that looks better, is more functional, and a lot cheaper. Otherwise, you know, I can't really recommend, at the moment, I can't recommend Dia and Company to anybody who is even on the low end of middle class. Definitely not to somebody who's poor. So, I'll give him another shot and see what happens. Just to give you an idea of what kind of clothing I wear when I go outside, I bought this shirt and cardigan wrap, I'm not sure what to call it, at Lane Bryant last summer to go to a wedding. I wore it with a pair of black dress pants, and I don't normally go for white, but this worked for me, and the sleeves aren't the longest, but they at least cover the majority of what I don't want seen. The neckline is good. I'm fine with showing my cleavage. And this covers me well. And my jeans are functional. They have back pockets so I can put my wallet. They have front pockets so I can put my cell phone in. And the front pockets are deep. I can put the cell phone all the way down into my pocket and it's not going to fall out. And, you know, pocket both sides, back pocket both sides. That's how I like my jeans. If I go out, I have to have them functional. I have to be able to do stuff in them.